When you create materials and textures, you work with pixels that have colors or values. These pixels are stored on your computer as numbers. Your computer doesn't have infinite memory and processing powers, so these numbers need to be limited in size and precision. This video explains how these limits affect your materials and textures. There are two important things to understand. One, the value range your data has, that is, how far below or above zero the data can go. And two, the precision of the data you store, that is, how finely decimal values are divided when stored. Some data might need to represent a really broad value range, while other data needs to be very precise. Sometimes, both range and precision are important because they're tied together and influence each other. First, it's good to know how grayscale values and colors are stored. For a grayscale value, your computer will store a single number per pixel. For colors, however, it will store at least three values, one each for red, green, and blue. If your image has a transparent component, it will also store an additional alpha value. Such grayscale red, green, blue, and alpha values are called channels. In most cases, your data doesn't need to be that precise. Most color values are stored with 8-bit precision. Now, 8-bit might sound very retro, but it basically means a value is represented by 8 slots of a single bit that can be either 0 or 1. These two possibilities per slot give us a total of 256 unique combinations. So if your computer stores a decimal value between 0 and 1 as an 8-bit number, it has to be translated into one of those 256 possibilities. RGB colors, on the other hand, use 3 sets of 8-bit values, so they can be translated into 256 times 256 times 256 possibilities. So that's 16,777,216 different colors, which tends to be enough in most cases. The naming of RGB colors can be a bit confusing here. A 3 times 8-bit color would technically be a 24-bit color, but some software, like Substance 3D Designer or Painter, might refer to the precision of each channel, meaning an 8-bit per channel color. Single 8-bit colors do exist, but as there are only so few of these colors, just 256, they are never used these days. While describing a color with 8 bits per channel might be precise enough, 8-bit grayscale only has 256 steps, which is not a lot. This can be a problem depending on how your 8-bit grayscale map is used. If it's purely visual, like a noise uses a mask for a color or a roughness value, you won't see any issues. But if the grayscale map drives very faint, sloping gradients, or it gets converted to geometric data like height or normal, those 256 steps of an 8-bit map can quickly become obvious to the human eye. That's where more precise bit depths come to the rescue. The bit depth of an image is the precision of an image, the number of bits we use for its pixel values. 16-bit isn't just 2 times 8-bit. It has 65,536 different value steps, which is 256 times the precision of 8-bit. 16-bit is usually enough, but in rare cases, you might want to use 32-bit precision, which gives you billions of values. And yes, colors described as 16-bit per channel also exist, and they give you 281 trillion possible colors. There are some downsides to high bit depths, though. Bits are stored in your computer's memory or on your disk, so more bits means higher memory usage. High precision values are also slower to calculate. So far, when talking about grayscale values and colors, we've assumed that values lie in a limited range between 0 and 1, where black is 0 and white is 1. In many cases, that range is all we need. Sometimes, however, it's too limited. A good example is an environment panorama map used to light a 3D scene. A map like this contains lighting information, like the intensity of the sun. So a limited range of 0 to 1 isn't enough. That's because when your screen shows both a cloud and the sun as white, the difference in intensity between them is enormous. Another example would be a height map that contains negative as well as positive values. This lets you deform a mesh both inwards and outwards. All these cases, where we need values beyond 0 or 1, call for high dynamic range, or HDR. By default, HDR needs higher precision than 8-bit per channel, as that would just be too limited. You can imagine we need many more steps if our range gets bigger. So, HDR is stored as 16 or 32-bit. An interesting fact about high ranges and high bit depths is that those 65,000 steps aren't spaced out the same way over the entire range. Because of the way values are stored, we get greater precision between 0 and 1, but beyond that, precision gradually decreases, with large numbers being much less precise. High precision and high dynamic range are not automatically the best choice for your textures. To optimize performance and memory usage, it's best to use the lowest precision required. But for some texture types, like height maps, normal maps, and light environments, they really benefit from greater precision and range. So, let's sum things up. Visual maps and channels, like base color, roughness, or even just photographs, do not need high precision. Even if they're in grayscale, 8-bit per channel is a good choice here. Data maps that affect geometry and surfaces, like height maps and normal maps, can really benefit from higher 16-bit precision to avoid artifacts like dithering, banding, or stepping. HDR, high dynamic range, is the heaviest type of value you can use, with bit depths of up to 32-bit. Use them only when necessary, like with environment panoramas that contain lights or with certain specific height maps. To round things off, let's take a quick look at how you can change bit depth and range in Substance 3D Designer and Painter. In Designer, for a selected node, find the base parameters rollout in the Properties window. Output format is where you change bit depth and range. It doesn't matter if something is grayscale or color, the format is per channel. It's often locked or set by the previous node, so click the blue dropdown and choose Absolute to unlock the value. In Painter, find the Texture Set Settings view and scroll down to the channels. For each channel, click the gear icon to choose the format. Unlike Designer, Painter lets you specifically decide if a channel is color or grayscale. With that, I hope that bit depths and ranges now make more sense to you. Good luck mastering those pixels!